Ah, hello again, people. Up in front of the camera today, we have got two of Horstmann Kmk 2. In today's video, what we're going to do is I'm going to perform a little bit of surgery, shall we say, on those time switches up in front of the camera there. And what I'm going to do is the time switch on the right, I'm going to remove that enclosing can with the flap cover on it, and I am going to place it onto the nice new minty condition time switch on the left. Okay, therefore making up a nice new and complete time switch. Okay, the time switch on the left even has its terminal block. Okay, so there we go. It's got its terminal block. And in front of the camera today, we are going to do a little bit of surgery on those time switches. And to do that, you do need a flat-bladed screwdriver, like so. Okay, I'm not sure if you're going to get on that. There we go. Okay, flat-bladed screwdriver. Not too big at all. Okay, so first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the time switch on the right, and we'll have that enclosing can off of that time switch. Okay, let's just move that terminal block to one side. Let's just set that one down like so, so it doesn't fall over and break. And then this one, I'm just going to lie it down like so, very gently of course, and then I shall pick the camera up and we shall take a look at what's on the back of that enclosing can. Here we go. Okay, as you can see, there are three flathead screws. 1, 2, and 3. Now, to remove one of these enclosing cans, all you do, 1, 2, and 3, open the cover and then lift. Okay, you don't need to, shall we say, perform the same sort of procedure as you would on VMK7 SRS, because on one of those wires go in right underneath there, and to get the enclosing can off one of those, you've got to unplug the wires, the synchro motor wires, from the terminal block and push all of that inside the can, so that then this would then lift up, but not on a KMK2. All you do, 1, 2, 3, and lift. Okay, because that hole, it has been sliced right the way down to the front, and therefore it will just lift off without having to play around with that grommet or the wires that go through it. Okay, so 1, 2, and 3, open the cover and then lift. Let's do it now. The screws are done up too tight, people. I'm going to have to put the camera down. Please bear with me just a moment. And here we go. That's one. I'm just going to loosen the screws off with the screwdriver, and then I shall continue to loosen them off by hand. So that's one. There we go. That's one little screw. I've got a feeling the mechanism inside is hugging. Yeah, the mechanism inside is hugging the screws. So I'm going to have to lift that up in order to get the screws out. Screw number two. And, I've dropped into the pin base. And there's screw number three. I'm just going to lie that down like so. Okay. There's the three little screws just there. You do need to keep hold of those, because on the time switch over there, this one, it's only got one screw holding on that enclosing can. So when I do the surgery and put this can on that one over there, those screws will follow over onto that other one. Okay, so we've now got our three screws out of that enclosing can. We then just stand it up like so, open the cover, and it should just lift out. There we go. Okay, 1 kmk2 minus its enclosing can, and there we go. And you can see what I'm saying about that being sliced right to the front there. It just allows it to lift straight off. There's no markings or anything in there. There's that phone again. Darned phone. So there's the enclosing can. And there we go. So we've now got our three little screws there and one separated enclosing can. Let's have a look on the back of this while I've got the cover off, because it would be rude not to. There we go, you can see all the gears and workings inside there. There we are. That part there is the solder dial mechanism. Okay. Again, on these, you loosen that solar dial off by turning that knob in the middle. Like so. And then it just lifts off. There we go. Okay, that's an entire solar dial mechanism there. There we go. What I will say, just as a side note, okay, slightly off topic here. If you've got a solar dial Sangamo, okay, that nut in the middle, do not loosen it off. Okay, otherwise, if you do, all the solar dial mechanism falls to pieces. Okay, on a Sangamo, like on a S254 or whatever, there's a little screw just in the middle there. You loosen that screw off, and then it lifts off. Okay, so on a Sangamo, this is a Horstmann, on a Sangamo, do not loosen that nut off in the middle, because if you do, the solar dial mechanism falls to pieces and you are stuffed. Okay, they vary from one manufacturer to another, and on a Horstmann, you do loosen that central nut off in order to remove it. Okay, and similar to a Sangamo, you do have those slices cut out of there so that you can loosen that off for whatever reason. Maybe you want to put a 24-hour dial on there, and then you just plop it back on there, and it allows you to realign it. It drops back on, and then you do up the central nut again to hold it in place. Okay, like so. Let's look on the back now. And straight away we can see the synchro motor. Now, interestingly, that synchro motor looks very, very similar to what you'd get in a Horstmann VMK7 SRS. But the difference with this is that motor is wired straight to the pin base. Okay? In a VMK7, one of those wires comes out, and then it goes into an escape point interrupter, and said escape point interrupter and the synchro motor are wired in series. Now, this KMK2 does not have a spring reserve, therefore it does not need the escape point interrupter, so the motor therefore is wired straight to the pin base. Okay. But yes, that motor on there does look very, very similar to what you'd get on a VMK7. I don't think, however, you could get that motor out of there and put it into a VMK7, because If you did, you would then have to wire that in series with an escapement interrupter. And as such, but due to it being then wired in series with an escapement interrupter, it would probably undervolt it, and as such would run slower. Okay, although it's a synchro motor and they run on the mains AC sine wave and the 50 hertz alternation frequency, they do need a certain voltage. Okay, I could be wrong on that. There might be someone out there who knows technical on these motors, and yeah, they may have a broad operating voltage. Let's say, for example, that motor in there will run somewhere between, it'll run quite happily somewhere between 170 and 250 volts without no slowdown due to it being a synchro motor. I don't know. Okay, so there we go. We're 11 minutes in now and I'm waffling on a bit. That time switch over in the back there, over in the background, that needs its can removing now. So I'm going to put this one to one side. Okay. There we go. Now this one, if I bring this one over and lie it down, I'll tip it over. You can see that it's only got one screw holding on that can. Okay, there it is. Just there. Okay. So I'm going to loosen that off now. And once again, loosen the screw off. And the can just pulls off. Okay, that's the screw removed, and one, two, three, and it's off. And once again, you can see inside there, it's got the synchro motor again. Okay, exactly the same layout as the other one, nothing special. And there's inside, a look inside the enclosing can. And as you can see what I mean when I say that it's been sliced right up to the front there. So it just slides off. You don't need to do all that hocus pocus that you would associate with a VMK7 SRS. Okay, it just slides straight off. And one enclosing can. Nothing wrote inside there. No stamp marks or anything. So there we go. That's that out of here. That little screw that came with it, that will have to follow over to the other time switch. Okay. Now, this one, because that this enclosing can, you need three fixings with it. You can already see that this time switch has got the three fixings on it. Okay. Now, those posts, right? They are a dual function role. You might be able to see, there it is, there's a fixing bracket just there. I will get a zoom on it, well, I will try to get a zoom on it, but you know this camera's like the zoom. Right, I'm not sure if you can get on that. But, between that fixing post and this end plate, there is a bracket for that synchro motor. Okay, so the way this works is there's a threaded post sticking out of this end plate. You put the synchro motor on, and then to hold on the synchro motor, you then screw these posts, these securing posts, onto that thread there, and then that holds the synchro motor in. And then in this end here, there are threaded holes for our enclosing can. Okay, so those fixing posts, another one right up top there, two, and that one over there, number three, they perform two functions, okay? They not only hold on the enclosing can, they also secure the synchro rotor into place. So, if you're ever thinking about loosening those off, Be aware that when you remove them, the synchro motor will drop out. Okay, and they have provided a facility for loosening those posts off. You can see on there, they've milled in little grooves into that threaded end. And into that threaded groove, into those little grooves, you can put a screwdriver in there. Okay, like so. You see? So you can then loosen off these threaded, internally threaded posts. And once you loosen those off, the synchro motor then releases. So there we go, it's a little bit of side information there on how those synchro motors are secured to the back of the time switch mechanism. Okay, so there we go. I've had a look around in there already, and it is nice and new in there. There is no wear on those cogs at all. So there we go. Let's put that can on now and get it tightened up. Okay, it's slotted into place. Let's close the flap cover like so. And there it is. And those holes are lining up perfectly. We now put our screws in. That's one. Two, and here goes the third one. And there's the third one, all in place now, like so. And that terminal block over there, because that belongs with this time switch, let's plug it onto its terminal block, like so. And as you can see now, that is one complete time switch. Okay. And that, as you see it there, that would be just mounted to a wall like that, in situ, and that would be it. And of course, once that terminal block is wired, secured to the wall, to remove the time switch, you just pull it. And it would disconnect from the terminal block, and the terminal block would obviously still be fixed to the wall with the wires coming out of the bottom of it. Okay, so there we go. We'll just put this one back together. There's a little screw in the bottom there. That goes on like so. Do up the one little screw. And there we are. Transfer complete. That one, because it is broken, that can go into my box of spares. It's an old junker. And this one is the nice new complete one. Nice, clean, minty condition where the mechanism is and the specification plate and the terminal block. But that can on there, you can clearly see it's been dented in. I will have to carefully get the dents out of that. So there we go, people. One complete KMK2. Thanks for watching.